a labyrinth of human curiosity, where science pushes the boundaries of understanding, certain figures emerge whose work sparks a quiet revolution. Dr. Michael Persinger was one such pioneer, a man whose groundbreaking research explored the mesmerizing intersection between the human mind and the Earth's magnetic field. While his ideas may seem fantastical at first glance, they force us to reconsider what we know about consciousness, reality, and the mysterious forces that govern human connection. Could the Earth's magnetic field, an invisible, omnipresent force, hold the secret to our thoughts, emotions, and even telepathic communication? Or, more intriguingly, could it be the hidden key to a global network of minds? Some believe Persinger's work was so revolutionary that it attracted the interest of clandestine government projects like the CIA, which explored its potential for mind control, remote viewing, and even telepathy. Let's peel back the layers of this mystery and see what made Persinger's theories so compelling, so dangerous, and perhaps so true. Picture this: the Earth as a living, breathing organism. Not just a sphere teeming with life, but an entity with its own consciousness, pulsating with electromagnetic waves that flow through every corner of our planet. Dr. Persinger believed that this magnetic field, far from being a mere physical shield against cosmic radiation, could actually be an information highway, a vast web of energy through which human consciousness travels and interacts. To grasp this, imagine that every thought you've ever had, every emotional high and low, could leave an imprint on this magnetic field, a kind of cosmic graffiti, written by the human mind and waiting to be read by others. Persinger's theory postulates that the brain, which produces its own subtle electrical and magnetic signals, could tap into this larger field as a radio antenna tuned to an infinite frequency of human experience. If true, this would mean that the boundaries of our individual consciousness might be much more permeable than we think. The Earth's magnetic field could serve as a grand library, a reservoir of thoughts, memories, and emotions, all shared by every living mind, past, present, and future. Now, let's zoom in on how the human mind fits into this. According to Persinger, your brain isn't just a biological machine processing sensory input. It's more like a finely tuned instrument, capable of picking up on the subtle, unseen signals of the Earth's magnetic field. Under certain conditions, whether during sleep, meditation, or moments of heightened emotional intensity, the brain might open a window into this magnetic world, syncing with other minds in ways we can scarcely imagine. Ever felt a sudden, inexplicable connection with someone miles away, as though you were thinking the same thing at the same time? Persinger's research suggests that this might not be a coincidence. He hypothesized that the Earth's magnetic field acts like a massive communication system, enabling mental resonance between people. Thoughts and emotions ripple through this field like waves across a pond, subtly connecting us to one another without us ever realizing it. This doesn't mean we're all telepathic superhumans secretly communicating through the ether, but it does open up the tantalizing possibility that our brains are always communicating on a level below conscious awareness. When the conditions are right, these hidden connections may surface, manifesting as those odd moments of synchronicity where you share an unspoken understanding or an eerie premonition. One of Persinger's most mind-blowing theories was his concept of the global mind. The idea that individual human consciousness is not isolated, but part of a larger, interconnected network. According to this theory, your thoughts, emotions, and even dreams aren't locked inside your head, but are part of a worldwide web of mental connections, all linked by the Earth's magnetic field. Imagine that each brain is like a node in a global network, constantly transmitting and receiving signals from billions of other nodes. When you feel a sudden rush of emotion for no apparent reason, could it be that you're picking up on someone else's thoughts or feelings from halfway across the world? In Persinger's view, the Earth's magnetic field serves as a kind of medium through which this vast network of minds communicates. If this is true, then it would fundamentally change our understanding of reality. What if your most private thoughts aren't entirely your own, but are shaped by this collective mental field? What if your feelings of love, fear, or sadness are being amplified or influenced by the emotions of others, rippling through the magnetic field, reaching you like invisible radio waves. One of Persinger's most fascinating experiments involved testing whether two people could connect mentally without being in the same room. He conducted an experiment where one person watched a blinking light, while another person, in a separate room, was completely unaware of it. Strangely enough, the brain waves of the second person began to synchronize with the individual watching the light. How could this happen? Persinger suggested that the two individuals' brains were linked through the Earth's magnetic field. This invisible connection allowed them to share the same sensory experience, even though only one of them was consciously aware of it. This experiment, while still controversial, opens up a whole new realm of possibility. Could it be that, under certain conditions, our minds can share information directly, without the need for speech, sight, or physical presence? If our brains are capable of this kind of subtle synchronization, what else might be possible? Could telepathy, long dismissed as mere pseudoscience, actually be a latent human ability, facilitated by the Earth's magnetic field? Persinger's theories didn't just stop at the Earth's magnetic field. He also ventured into the world of quantum physics, drawing parallels between his ideas and the strange phenomenon of quantum entanglement. In quantum entanglement, two particles, even if separated by vast distances, remain connected in such a way that a change in one instantaneously affects the other. Persinger speculated that the human brain might operate similarly. He proposed that the photons emitted by the brain could become entangled with those of another person's brain, creating a direct, invisible connection between their minds. This quantum link, he believed, could be responsible for those moments of eerie coincidence when you think of someone right before they call, or when you share the same thought simultaneously with someone else. Could this be the scientific basis for what we've traditionally called intuition or even telepathy? Persinger's work suggests that our minds may not be as isolated as we think. Instead, they might be part of a vast quantum web, connected through the Earth's magnetic field, where thoughts and emotions can travel instantaneously between people, regardless of distance. One of the boldest aspects of Persinger's research was his theory that the Earth's magnetic field might act as a kind of cosmic archive, the universal database that stores the collective thoughts, emotions, and memories of all human beings. In this view, the magnetic field is more than just a protective layer around our planet. It is a vast, invisible library, filled with the echoes of every human experience. Imagine that every thought you've ever had, every dream, every memory, is not lost to time but preserved in the Earth's magnetic field. What if these experiences could be accessed by others, even long after you're gone? Persinger suggested that certain individuals, under the right conditions, might be able to tap into this global archive, retrieving memories and emotions from people long dead. It's a wild concept, but it offers a tantalizing explanation for phenomena like déjà vu, or the feeling that you've experienced something before, even though you know you haven't. Could it be that in these moments, you're accessing the thoughts or memories of someone else, imprinted on the Earth's magnetic field? What happens, though, when the Earth's magnetic field fluctuates? Persinger proposed that changes in geomagnetic activity could have a direct impact on human consciousness. During periods of calm geomagnetic activity, the mental space between individuals might be clearer, allowing for stronger connections between minds. But when geomagnetic storms occur, these connections could be disrupted, leading to feelings of disconnection or emotional turmoil. Imagine your brain as a finely tuned radio. When the signal is strong, everything is clear. But when there's interference, like during a geomagnetic storm, the signal becomes fuzzy and communication breaks down. Persinger believed that this could explain why people sometimes feel anxious, disoriented, or mentally cloudy during periods of high geomagnetic activity. It's not just the weather affecting you. It's the Earth's magnetic field throwing a wrench into the global network of minds. Persinger's work challenges us to rethink the boundaries of human consciousness. What if our minds are not limited to our physical bodies, but are part of a vast, interconnected web of thought and emotion, linked by the Earth's magnetic field? What if telepathy, intuition, and even collective emotions are real phenomena, shaped by this invisible force that surrounds us all? As we move further into the 21st century, we may find that the answers to some of our deepest questions about human consciousness lie not in new technology, but in the natural world itself. The Earth, with its magnetic field and quantum connections, might be the key to unlocking the mysteries of the mind, and perhaps the future of human evolution.